It's very difficult to tell you what happened to me when I saw you at Barrington's. I'd gone into the store to buy something. I can't remember what it was. And as I was walking through the Kodak department, I heard someone speaking German. I looked round and saw you. At first I couldn't believe my eyes. I stood and gazed at you and listened to your voice. I was still gazing at you when you turned and looked up into my face. Then I went completely mad, declared Charles. My first impulse was to seize you in my arms. But then in a flash I remembered that you were married. I wheeled and strode away as fast as I could, pushing through the crowd of people, roughly, rudely. I didn't care what they thought of me. As I was going down in the lift, I saw you again. But my anger had flared up, and my one idea was to escape from you. I found a taxi at the exit. The man was just about to drive away, but I wrenched the door open and jumped in. I went to the hotel and shut myself up in my room, and walked up and down for hours like a maniac. Seeing you like that so unexpectedly had stirred up my deepest feelings. I realized all I had lost. I realized that in spite of my pride, in spite of my resolutions to forget you and remake my life, I still loved you with every fiber of my being. And you were married to another man and had a child.
Oh, Charles, you might have known.
No, wait, he exclaimed. Now that I've started, I want to go on and tell you everything. It isn't easy, Sarah.
I nodded and made up my mind not to interrupt him again.
A week passed, he continued. Or perhaps it was more. I don't know how long.